All been coming to a head until now, today's fire.
Michelle wanted to show me more of the slum. She told me millions of poor people live like this, with little help from the government.
Poor people is become poor people, stay still poor, and the rich people become rich. Rich, 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 rich.
We were told that fires and evictions were not the only methods being used in this class war.
Mary?
I'd arranged to meet Guy Portahada, who told me many people fighting for the rights of the poor were going missing. She helps the families of those who have disappeared.
How many people are disappearing?
Since 2001 of 2000.
Guy told me scores of people are going missing every year, and that all of them had been campaigners for social change.
So Guy's saying that, in fact, over the past 7 years, there have been 193 cases of abductions. So what do you do now?
I try to help the other families.
She told me she'd been driven to help others following the abduction of her own father, a union leader, when she was just 11.
I feel alone and sad. What happened to my father?
We joined Guy as she went to investigate a recent disappearance. We picked up Nanny Chris. She told us her husband, Abner, had been a lifelong activist who had worked with poor farmers. He went missing several months ago.
This is the place where it happened.
Okay. Chris is saying that on March the 22nd last year, her husband was riding a small tricycle like this one. He got to this point and a white van pulled up in front of him. A couple of men came out of the buildings just next to us and grabbed him and shoved him into the van. The men were all wearing white shirts, camouflage pants and combat boots and carrying M16 automatic weapons, and nobody's heard from him since.
Guy told us the description of men in military uniforms is the same in almost every case of abduction that she's investigated.
Just been allowed to come into the hospital, they're going to hopefully check the records to see if his picture has turned up, basically, if his body's been brought in.
After months without news, Chris told us she feared for the worst.
He hasn't been admitted to hospital either as a patient or dead.
It seemed as if Abner's entire existence had been virtually erased.
How does it affect you?
Of course, it's very hard for us. We can't do anything.
Chris is just saying that just 2 weeks ago, she moved out the double bed they used to use and moved in a bunk for her daughter and niece, and she now sleeps in a single bed here. I guess it's perhaps part of a gradual acceptance that that he might not be coming back.
Guy claims that in addition to the 193 missing without explanation, more than 900 social activists are said to have been assassinated by military death squads.
So we've come to this village because we've heard of another disappearance, and in this time they've got some evidence about who did it. Hi, Connie.
Good morning.
Hi, I'm Evan.
I'm Mrs. Mpen. I'm Mrs. Mother of Karen.
Okay.
I'm Connie Mpen, your mother of Karen.
Right, and this is your daughter who went missing.
Karen Mpenyo was a student activist who went missing 2 years ago. We arrive on what would have been her 25th birthday.
Room that we have.
So this is Karen's room?
Her mother, Connie, wanted to show me some of Karen's possessions. They included a scrapbook Karen had made of her life.
I mean, it's a very moving scrapbook, and it shows a girl who's not only done extremely well in school, but also is very creative. And one of the sayings she's got in there is, lots of people chase their dreams, but you caught yours. And then it shows a picture of her graduating from high school. And
tragedy of this is that what's happened means that this is a very promising life that's been stolen. What do you find personally the hardest thing to go through?
I do not know where she is. I do not want to think. Because what I'm hoping is that Karen will be coming home still alive.
Connie told me Karen was studying social reform and had been interviewing farmers for her thesis when she went missing. She showed me sworn statements from two witnesses who described how Karen was abducted from the farmhouse where she was staying.
We saw at least five armed men wearing fatigues and other in civilian clothes, but were wearing combat shoes. That is why we thought that these men outside our house were from the military.
This is Karen's father, Oscar. He told me he believed Karen had been targeted because she was an active campaigner against government corruption.
Once you are an organizer, once you are an activist, they call you a communist. That means you are an enemy of the state. When you are an enemy of the state, they can abduct you, they can harass you, they can kill you. Anything. That's the killing machine of the president, the military.
For 2 years, they've had no news of their missing daughter. We had heard many allegations that soldiers were behind the killings and abductions, but proving they were being conducted with official sanction by army death squads was more difficult.
I've been trying to find somebody from within the military who can verify that they are in fact being used to target left-wing civilians. It's quite difficult, and we've been told to come to this office block in the middle of Manila. We can't say where it is or who we're seeing, but somebody here, we're told, might be able to help us.
For his security, we can't identify the man we met. He told me he was an ex-army corporal and was coming forward now to express his anger at what soldiers are ordered to do.
What he's saying is that there's a special group within the military which is specifically targeting civilians, suspected left-wing people, suspected communists, human rights workers, and they operate within the regiment camp, Camp Texon, that he was in, independently. They have their own password, their own processes, they don't have to answer to anybody else, and they have a safe house inside the military camp where they bring civilian detainees who they interrogate and torture. What are you told as soldiers about the threat from left-wing groups?
He told me soldiers are taught that